Greetings. I was thinking this morning about the desperate claims by Mohammed that he was foretold. And I asked myself the following question. If Mohammed was not foretold, does that disqualify him as a prophet? Newsflash, I don't think it does. But that does not mean he is therefore a prophet of God. Because even if Mohammed was not foretold, because Mohammed claimed he was, which would mean Mohammed lied. And his lies would disqualify Mohammed as a prophet. But that then led me to begin to examine which other prophets were foretold. And was their status as prophet predicated on being foretold? So I began at Moses and thought about Moses. And Moses presents an interesting schism. Moses recorded the Pentateuch, or the Torah, in which Moses describes not only himself, but prophets before him. This being the case that Moses detailed past history, mentioning known, accepted prophets who came before him, we do not have the opportunity to examine more ancient text before those prophets which would document that they were foretold. But Moses recorded the lives and accomplishments of several prophets of God. Aaron, Abraham in Genesis, and himself, for example. And Moses foretold one other prophet in Deuteronomy 18. But other than this mention of another prophet like Moses, he did not foretell any others. After Moses and the Torah that he wrote, the Old Testament is filled with messages written by the prophets of God. You can look at the book of Judges, for example. In fact, I even found this information on the wiki of all things. Prophets of Christianity. In Christianity, the historical figures widely recognized as prophets are those mentioned as such in the Hebrew Bible and the canonical New Testament. The main list below consists of only those individuals who have been clearly defined as prophets, either by explicit statement or strong contextual information. The authors of the book listed as the major prophets and minor prophets, along with the biblical reference to their office. And then in the list it gives the alphabetical listing of these named prophets. Aaron, Abel, Abraham, Abagus, Agur, Ahijah, Amos, Anna, Asaph, Azariah, Barnabas, Daniel, David, Deborah. But my study is really about the order of the prophets, so I was looking for time order beginning with Genesis. So here I see Genesis because Abraham was described in Genesis. In the next group, none were written of in Genesis. Elijah, Elisha, Enoch, Ezekiel, Gad, Habakkuk, Haggai, Hosea, Huldah. I hadn't even ever heard of Huldah before. Iddo and Isaiah. In the next group, we see Jacob written of in Genesis. And Miriam in Exodus and Moses in Deuteronomy. Nahum, Nathan, Noah, Obadiah, Obed, Philip the Evangelist, Paul the Apostle, Samuel, Shemaiah, Silas, Simeon, Niger. And here we see Noah was written of in Genesis. And here the final entries in the list from Wikipedia. The two witnesses of Revelation, Urijah, Zechariah, and Zephaniah. So there are a handful mentioned in Genesis by Moses. Abraham, Noah, Moses himself, and I noticed Enoch was not included in the list in Genesis, because clearly Enoch is mentioned in Genesis 5, 22 through 29. It says, Enoch walked with God, which is some evidence that Wiki is a great starting point, but must always be considered suspect. As I looked into the prophets in Genesis, I noticed only Moses was predicted in any way. The Jewish people were looking for a deliverer. But I honestly cannot find any scripture that foretells of Moses coming. And if you gave it much thought, you would recognize how self-serving it might appear for Moses to write his own foretelling. Since Moses scribed the Torah, the first five books in which he appears, and with good reason, too. any man claiming the word of God which he, the man, delivered, foretold of him, should be tossed out on his ear. That is why all of Muhammad's claims are so easy to reject and dismiss out of hand, with no need even to consider all the other evidence against him. But the point of this research and study is to examine the pattern of foretelling, especially as it applies to granting credentials to anyone who claimed to be a prophet. And the pattern we begin to see is that very few prophets were foretold. But think about it. The important part of God's message is the message, not the messenger. But there are a few breadcrumbs enough to establish continuity. Prophet Isaiah had a laser-like accuracy. He foretold the virgin birth. He foretold the voice in the wilderness. He foretold God giving his son. And many other prophets confirmed the existence of God's son. But very few prophets mentioned later prophets. Again, the point of their message was to reveal God and his plan. Now, I want to go back to Wiki for just a moment because they had a great summary statement about the prophets, specifically the book of Judges. The book of Judges is the seventh book of the Hebrew Bible and the Christian Old Testament. Its title describes its contents. It contains the history of biblical judges, divinely inspired leaders whose direct knowledge of Yahweh allows them to act as champions for the Israelites from oppression by foreign rulers, and models of wise and faithful behavior required of them by their God, Yahweh, following the exit from Egypt and the conquest of Canaan. The stories follow a consistent pattern. The people are unfaithful to Yahweh, and he therefore delivers them into the hands of their enemies. The people repent and entreat Yahweh for mercy, and he sends in the form of a leader or champion, a judge. The judge delivers the Israelites from oppression, and they prosper. But soon they fall again into unfaithfulness, and the cycle is repeated. And even that brief summary was beyond Muhammad's awareness and comprehension. And I know he wasn't around to read the wiki on the internet. You see, over and over, Muhammad claims knowledge of the prophets and their interaction with Israel, but he gets it wrong over and over. Muhammadism claims that the message of God kept getting changed, and the prophets had to restore it. But nowhere in the Word of God is there any text or message by the prophets stating that. You see, the prophets kept pointing the people back to the word of God they had, and no prophets ever demanded that Israel swear an oath to both them and God. That is a really troubling thing for Muhammadism. The Shahada is essentially a declaration that Muhammad is the partner of his Allah. You cannot consider yourself a member of the Muslim Mouse Club if you do not swear to Muhammad. And no other prophet ever required you swearing obedience to them, to the prophet. And I challenge every Mohammedan on earth to produce book and chapter and verse of any prophet doing so. So the point of this study is to understand if foretelling is the primary source of a prophet's credentials. The reality is no. Being foretold is not the way prophets made their claims to being prophets. I can only think of two examples where the prophet made mention to a previous prophecy. Jesus, the Son of God, who claimed he was the prophet Moses spoke of, and John, who applied the prophecy of the voice in the wilderness, who would prepare a path for God in the earth. Beyond these two, I do not know of any other such claims, but if you know of any, please let me know. When Elijah was leaving, he told Elisha something specific, but that is different because they spoke face to face. And it came to pass when they were gone over that Elijah said unto Elisha, "Ask what I shall do for thee before I be taken away from thee." And Elisha said, I pray thee, let a double portion of thy spirit be upon me. And Elijah said, Thou hast asked a hard thing. Nevertheless, if you see me when I am taken from you, it shall be so unto you. If not, it shall not be so. Given more than 40 prophets in the Old and New Testaments were mentioned, I think the pattern is clear. A prophet being foretold is not the source of his credentials. So then how did anyone prove they were a prophet? They proved it by example, demonstration. Sometimes they knew things that only God could know. God had revealed his knowledge to them. Sometimes they did things that only God could do. God used his power on their behalf. When a man does things that all men can do, like talking or storytelling, there is nothing being demonstrated to prove the man is special. But when a man does things which no man can do, and only God can do, then you know the man is special, speaking on behalf of something greater than men. And this was the very challenge Muhammad faced, making his claim as a prophet. Muhammad could not do anything to prove he was special. Muhammad claimed he was only a warner, only a talker, someone who told stories. Muhammad was not special, and God did not supply any evidence to change that judgment. And why was that a problem for Muhammad? Because God did not send Muhammad, God would not show God's power on Muhammad's behalf. But Muhammad was clever in his arguments and excuses. Muhammad claimed previous miracles had caused people to worship the prophets. But that is stupid on its face. No one worshipped Moses or Elijah or Elisha. All the prophets directed worship to the God of all. The only example Mohammedans can hope or try to offer is Jesus. And rightly so, because Jesus said and did things no other prophet did before him. But Christians do not worship Jesus because of magic tricks. We worship Jesus because Jesus demonstrated by example that God endorsed everything Jesus said. We worship Jesus because Jesus healed the blind eyes, deaf ears, lame legs, lepers, and raised the dead. And to every one of those truths, the Mohammedan mind is conditioned to repeat the lie, by Allah's permission. We worship Jesus because he said he is the Son of God. So we worship Jesus because he is the Son of God. Jesus was the Redeemer foretold by the prophets. So a prophet being foretold is not the source of credentials. But God does foretell things that are important. God foretold the coming of his son through a virgin birth. God foretold of the prophet, John, who would precede his son, God, in the earth. God has foretold how the end of days would conclude. And we see those signs coming to pass and the end approaching daily. May the God who has revealed himself to man by the prophets open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, who was revealed by the prophets, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.